Item 4 on the order of paper is the adjournment. The question is that the Assembly do now adjourn, and in conjunction with the Business Committee, I have given leave to Catherine Seeley to raise the matter of investing in town centres in Upper Bann. The proposer of the motion will have 15 minutes, and all other speakers will have approximately 15 minutes. Éireann or Double Eshbail, 5 minutes. So I just repeat that for in case there's any confusion. The proposer of the motion will have 15 minutes, and all other speakers will have approximately 5 minutes. Éireann or Catherine Seeley. I call Catherine Seeley.
Gurren mé agat, Madam Deputy Principal Speaker. Madam Deputy Principal Speaker, I'm very proud to be from Upper Bann. Upper Bann sits just 30 minutes outside of Belfast. We have excellent rail links, although they could be improved if they were extended to Armagh. Great access to the motorway, numerous booming industrial estates with big names employing many, and many huge tourist attractions, including Oxford Island, the People's Park, Lurgan Park and Brownlow Castle. So it truly is a place we can work, live and play. I want to take this opportunity to commend the businesswomen and men of Upper Bann who work tirelessly to contribute to our economy. Endless hours spent, often simply making ends meet, surviving from one month to the next. Our bustling side streets with our independent retailers, butchers, fed shops are the heart and soul of our towns. There is nothing quite like the meat from Jim McCann's and Finty O'Hagan's, the fruit and veg from Hendersons, the unique gifts from Danann Crafts, or the mouth-watering food from our bustling restaurant scene. I want to also commend the efforts of both Banbridge and Portadown's Chamber of Commerce. The Finance Minister recently met with Banbridge Chamber of Commerce and witnessed firsthand the sterling work they do, and he will hopefully accept an invitation to meet with the Portadown Chamber of Commerce and representatives from Lurgan retailers in the coming months. And finally, I want to praise Armagh, Banbridge and Craigavon Boroughs Council officers. We are the second largest council in the north. I meet with them regularly, as I'm sure my colleagues from Upper Bann do as well, and they work tirelessly to draw down funding, to target it to where it is needed the most. They listen and engage with our retailers, and they're currently developing a tourism strategy around our town centres, and it's often their innovative ideas that breathe some life back into our town centres. However, sadly, this is not the reason I rise in this chamber today. I rise as a result of extensive lobbying during the course of the recess from small and medium-sized businesses in our three town centres, Lurgan, Banbridge and Portadown, concerned for their future and the erosion of our town centres, despite the endless efforts of the many I have mentioned. We are all too aware of the problems, rates, a lack of parking, decreased footfall, competition from shopping centres, not helped, of course, by the Northern Irish weather, and more recently, Brexit. Yet town centres are the social centres of our constituencies. They offer people the opportunity to meet, talk, and more importantly, buy local produce. It is the very character of our town centres that gives our constituencies their identity. I will indeed, yep.
Exactly, could she state to this House exactly what effect would the Brexit vote have had in terms of the economies of the cities she's, or towns she's mentioned?
Well, I can use a very particular example of a trader in Lurgan that trades across the border and who is worried that the trading across the border will be impacted by tariffs that traders may have to pay and that she'll lose that. As I was saying, they are not competing on a level playing field and they need our help. They are a significant part of our national and local economy. They provide jobs, distribute goods and services and are a place of investment. And that's investment we cannot afford to slip away. Our town centres are much too valuable to our economy and local community to be left to market forces alone. And to see their contribution to the economy and society being steadily eroded is concerning. We must therefore do all in our power to reverse this decline. In the short term, this will, of course, require further investment, and I want to acknowledge the investment, certainly, that this institution has given to our council over the years. But the investment must go beyond the tidying up of shop fronts. It will also require forward and long-term thinking. For example, fragmentation is one of the key issues facing our town centres, and developing them on the basis that we develop our cities is a must, with restaurant quarters, market areas, a nighttime economy, strong transport links and good internet connections. We need to look into rates and how retailers can get more from them, such as marketing initiatives, and many have even asked that simply their bins be lifted or their water, as well as reduced rates for start-ups. Councils should be duty-bound to employ full-time dedicated town centre managers, focusing on marketing, increasing footfall and encouraging businesses and offices into our empty buildings. Armagh, Banbridge and Craigavon Borough Council has a business engagement programme, and during my time as a councillor I signposted many struggling businesses to this particular programme, which often was the difference in a business remaining open or closing its doors. This particular programme is now under threat as a result of funding pressures, but it is programmes such as this that must become the norm. I would call for a marketing strategy such as the one deployed in Lisburn. Online strategies such as Dungannon's Get Online campaign to be extended to the towns of Upper Bann. I touched on the importance of a nighttime economy earlier. Our towns should not be ghost towns as of 5 o'clock. 5 to 8 is one of the few time slots of growth in town centres' footfall, yet our shops are closed, and we must look at incentives to keep them open. With regard to derelict buildings, we must bring them back to life, not just by tidying them up, but by encouraging traders into them, as well as offices, educational buildings and council. All of this will increase footfall throughout the day, supporting our businesses as more people buy local. Some of the retailers I met over the summer recess complained that many of the successful and worthwhile and Fast NI initiatives focus on manufacturing, exports and the niche market, but we must ensure programmes are devised and aimed at supporting our retailers. Madam Deputy Principal Speaker, none of this can be achieved in silos. We need a plan. We need regional government on a cross-departmental basis, working with local government, who are working with traders together to invest effectively in our town centres, bearing in mind that every town centre is different and unique. Moving forward, I hope Phase 2 of the Business Improvement Districts will include our towns in Upper Bann. I would also call for the creation of retailer hubs similar to the digital and innovation hubs that exist, as well as the further empowerment of our councils, particularly given their planning powers. And finally, targeted funding towards the development of our chambers of commerce so they can play a proactive role in the regeneration of our towns. I thank members for being here today and for showing interest in this motion, and I thank the Minister of Communities for being here as well, but would also note that other departments will need to be involved in this if we are to truly address the problem. Thank you.
Call Sydney Anderson.
Thank you, Madam Principal Deputy Speaker. Madam Principal Deputy Speaker, I welcome this opportunity today to speak on town centre investment in my constituency of Upper Bann, and I would have to declare an interest as I do have family involvement in small business in Portadown. We have three main historic towns of Portadown, Lurgan and Banbridge, and in more recent times we have seen the growth of Craigavon Centre. Each play an integral part in the local economy, but since the economic downturn, many businesses and shops have struggled and ceased to exist. In recent times, our towns have had to adapt and to develop to meet the demands of modern times. However, the economic downturn is not the only factor that has affected businesses. The advancement of technology has meant an ever-increasing amount of people making more use of online shopping opportunities rather than shopping in the towns themselves. And recently, the Consumer Council reported that almost half of Northern Ireland consumers shop online. Our town centres have also had to compete for trade with an ever-growing out-of-town shopping network. As such, they have found it harder to make their mark and attract the same level of investment that was seen in years gone by. Business rates have also proved challenging, with the Northern Ireland Independent Retail Trade Association recently noting that in Northern Ireland the level of vacant shops on the high street is nearly twice the UK national average. And whilst a number of efforts have been made to help revitalise and regenerate town centres in recent times by the local council and by the executive through small business rate relief and support schemes, Much more would need to be done to encourage investment and new start-ups in our town centres. With the introduction of the new councils across Northern Ireland, local government will have an increasing role to play in regeneration and economic development. On a personal level, in my time as a member of the former Craigavon Borough Council, I chaired the Economic Development Committee, which oversaw public realm schemes in Portadown and Lurgan, and there's work continuing, and plus other schemes which were seeking to help improve those two towns during those difficult times. And that's work that I and others did appreciate at the time, although there was maybe difficulties to get the work done within that specific period. But I think it has helped those towns, and I therefore feel it is imperative that the collaborative work between all key sector and levels of government continue to explore further ways in which town centre investment can be fostered and encouraged. In recent weeks, we saw the Banbridge Master Plan being launched by my colleague, the Minister for Communities, Paul Given, MLA. This plan sets out a clear vision for how the town centre aims to look over the next 15 years and incorporates a number of key regeneration proposals, including efforts to develop the evening economy and revitalisation projects to further enhance shop frontage and car parking. I would welcome these proposals, and I'm hopeful that the Master Plan will provide additional opportunities for growth in the town centre. It is also important that we continue to help drive investment within Portadown and Lurgan town centres, with efforts focused on developing the nighttime economy and efforts being made to attract a range of different types of business that appeal to the consumer. Ultimately, the key to encouraging investment in our town centres is that we continue to engage positively with the business sector to further drive investment and further encourage people to start business in our towns. Adopting a positive vision is key as we seek to identify good practice and also to promote and to advertise what our town centres have to offer, not only within the local area but right across Northern Ireland. Going forward, we need to continue to liaise with key stakeholders such as Chambers of Commerce in each of the towns, the local council, and with the various departments and ministers of the executive on these matters in an effort to assist investment and help restore the town centres within Upper Bann. As I have already said, Upper Bann's town centres have a great history and have much to offer, and it is vital that we all harness that potential in the years ahead, and I look forward to the Minister's comments. Thank you, Madam Principal Deputy Speaker.
I call Joanne Dobson.
Thank you, Madam Principal Deputy Speaker. Can I also thank the member for bringing this debate to the Chamber this afternoon? And at the outset, I will be the only Ulster Unionist contributing. My colleague Doug Biddy, MC, has asked me to give his apologies. Investing in town centres is a crucial issue for economic stability and jobs right across Upper Bann, for Portadown, Lurgan and Banbridge, but equally the smaller villages from Guildford to Loughbrickland and from Waringstown to Donaghcloney. Madam Principal Deputy Speaker, the bottom line is that whilst it is important to continue to invest, improve and innovate our town centres, it is equally important that the Executive fully supports the small businesses who trade there. That requires a sea change in the silo mentality often adopted by government departments. To give just one example, last year saw investment in town centre public realm works on the one hand, whilst on the other hand, small businesses suffered from a re-rating exercise which was nothing short of a shambles. Thousands of small businesses, many of them family owned for generations, rightly appealed, with many of those appeals eventually being upheld. I know for many of the dozens of small businesses I represented to DFP last year, this often meant cancelling plans to expand their business or not taking on a new member of staff. So, Madam Principal Deputy Speaker, government must not give on the one hand and take away on the other. Investment in town centre infrastructure must therefore go hand in hand with packages of support for small businesses which help them to grow and to expand. Public realm works encourages business to invest, and the executive must foster that investment and business growth to its full potential. The fact that aspects of government policy impacts on local families, whether business owners or employees, must never be forgotten. I very much welcome the action which has been taken to progress town centre public realm works, including, and I'm sure the Minister will refer to it later on, the Banbridge Master Plan. I commend the Chamber of Commerce and especially the Banbridge Regeneration Committee for their ongoing work and commitment to their communities. And I encourage the Minister to ensure that, and thinking particularly of the Banbridge plans, that local business community and residents have the full opportunity to have their say and have their views listened to and taken on board. If investment is to be successful, both businesses and residents must feel ownership of change. I therefore also urge the Minister that when plans are being progressed by his department, that he ensures that everyone has an equal opportunity to benefit when it comes to initiatives like shopfront schemes, town centre Wi-Fi or public realm works. So positive changes, which may have been a very long time coming, should be allowed to have the maximum impact. Madam Principal Deputy Speaker, again, can I thank the Member for bringing this debate, and I very much look forward to hearing what the Minister has to say.
I call Carla Lockhart.
Thank you, Madam Principal Deputy Speaker. Like the speakers that have went before, I just want to give a wee outline in terms of Upper Bann. It has a very unique mix of town centres, and as my colleague Sydney Anderson alluded to, you have Lurgan, Banbridge and Portadown, and you also have the new town of Craigavon, all with their own unique portfolio of retailers and the way in which they do business. And as I was thinking of this debate, I was thinking of each of the towns and each of the different needs within the towns. And I was thinking about Lurgan, obviously, where I myself am based in an office. And we look at the investment that there has been. And I want, at this stage, I suppose, really to thank the former DSD ministers and their staff. And I also want to commend the council, the ABC Council and Craigavon. And I also want to thank the current minister as well for his interest in the area. I look at Lurgan and I see that Millennium Way is being progressed. That's a great asset for Lurgan, and I look forward to the completion of that. But there's still an elephant in the room with regards to the rail and railway halt and trying to get a solution around that. But I'm quite thankful, actually, when you look at the statistics, Lurgan's vacancy rate has actually reduced. And I think that's a positive step, and I think that shows that we're starting to get things working. You look at gap sites, maybe Castle Lane and the Clendenning site, and I think it's important that we look at those gap sites and that we do kind of look at the entire area and see where council or where this assembly can even invest in these gap sites. Whenever you move over to Portadown, you have a mix of family retailers and multinationals. There has been a significant amount of work done and investment around the town quay, and we welcome that, and I think that is something that can be further explored. You look at the People's Park as well, around the investment there, and I think there are still issues. We need to be looking at the Edward Street barrier in terms of the barrier that causes to the town as well, so that's something that we can address. And then whenever you move over to Banbridge, you have a very vibrant town, but as you look at the statistics, believe it or not, Banbridge is actually one of the towns which vacancy has increased, and that's worrying because Banbridge is always seen as a town that is bucking the trend. So I think we need a very clear, concerted effort, whether it be around a marketing strategy. We had the pleasure of having the Finance Minister in Banbridge very recently, along with the Communities Minister the day before, and there was a master plan designed around Banbridge, and I think that's very, very welcome. But I just don't want it to be a document. I want it to be a live document. I want to see the transportation strategy that the Minister committed to. I want to see that brought to fruition. I want to see a concerted effort by the executive to attract new businesses, because ultimately that's what we want to see, that's what we need to see. We need to see new entrepreneurs coming into our town centres. We need to encourage people to shop local. I'm an individual who loves shopping local, and we have got to encourage that, whether that be a Stormont-led initiative around shopping local, like what was suggested in Banbridge. I think that would be really, really welcome, and I think the traders would welcome it. I also think they're crying out for a regional marketing strategy off town centres, you know, so that people feel town centres are open for business. We have a fantastic mix of family-run and owned businesses. When you look at the employment that they create locally in each of our town centres, it's phenomenal, and I think we have got to really put our shoulders to the wheel and help these traders who have, through times of change, stuck with the town centres and actually invested in them. The rates issue is also an issue that we need to tackle. We know that the Finance Minister is bringing forward a review, and I would ask him to take a note of the representation that the businesses have made, particularly around how town centre, there seems to be a disparity between town centre and out of town. So I would really encourage the Finance Minister to look at that, and also the rating of the charity section. So I look forward, I think it's exciting times for town centre, and I really look forward to the Minister informing us exactly of what he is doing, and I want to commend them, because there's been over £11 million.
The Member's time is up. I call John O'Dowd.
Thank you, Mr. President. Congratulations to my colleague on bringing forward this motion for discussion today. And it is a mixture of good news and more challenges ahead. But as many of the speakers have outlined, there has already been significant investment in town centres across Upper Bann over this last decade. Now, some of the towns, and particularly in relation to Banbridge, it does require investment in its landscapes, in its footpaths, etc. And that I believe that investment can come about, and I welcome the interest shown by Minister Given, who was at the recent launch of the Banbridge Master Plan. That's signs that the executive is working. And I also noted during Minister Given's visit that he has funded a transportation plan, an infrastructure plan for Banbridge as well. Now, I commented at the time that the Minister could have stood back and said that's not my problem, go and see Minister Hazard. But I think it's a sign of the executive working together to help assist in bringing forward plans, in this case for town centres, which benefit the entire community and benefit the town centres, and in turn benefits our economy. Town centres have faced a number of challenges over this last 15 to 20 years. The introduction of out-of-town shopping was a significant challenge to the traditional town centre, and many of them failed to recover from out-of-town shopping being placed near them. I also think, and I've said this directly to traders, that many of them spent too long and too many debates debating what they didn't have and what the out-of-town shopping centre did have, instead of focusing on the uniqueness of the town centre, the family trader, the local produce, and the unique produce that they were selling in their town centres. So the envy of the out-of-town shopping centre has to end. They're here for the future. They're part of the make-up of our retail economy going into the future. And our town centres have to focus on the uniqueness of the brand they can deliver and sell. And I think there's a huge opportunity there. The other big challenge has been the turn to internet shopping. And this has been a challenge for international retail organisations, how they deal with the changing trend of the consumer in relation to buying products over the internet. And our town centres and our small retail businesses are having difficulties keeping up in pace with that. And perhaps that's an area where we should be assisting our small and medium businesses and how they engage in the internet, the online sales market, how they use their small businesses and promote them online, how they engage with the customer online, how they forward products, etc., going into the future. Because that is going to continue to be a significant part of retail going into the future. And if our small, medium businesses and our town centres are to survive, they have to be up to speed on selling their unique products online, as the large retailer is as well. Much has been discussed about rates, and rates are a challenge for small businesses, but I would put this measure of caution for people. If we cut rates in one area, it means there's a reduction in the rates coming into the executive, and the executive already faces huge financial challenges going into the future. But I do believe there is scope within the small business rates relief scheme for a new approach to it, and the Finance Minister has already said that that scheme is under review. I think there is scope there for small businesses to make their case heard. Who qualifies for the Small Business Relief Scheme, and how long that qualification lasts for, and what's the purpose of it? How does it promote the local economy going forward? So there is a lot of work going on, and we've already been noted. We've had Minister Given, Minister Hazard, we've had the Finance Minister in Upper Bann over this last number of months. So the Executive is paying attention to what's going on within the town centres in Upper Bann, and, as has been mentioned by Ms Dobson, some of the smaller villages in Guildford, Loch Brickland, and others in around the vicinity. So I think there is huge opportunities for the town centres in Upper Bann. There are challenges, but I do believe that the Executive is listening. I do believe that the local council is listening, but our role as elected representatives is to ensure that that engagement continues and that there's product at the end of that consultation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam Principal Deputy Speaker. As SDLP spokesperson on economy, I'm delighted to speak to this motion brought forward today. And in particular, whilst it is specific to the Upper Bann constituency, as a member from South Down, I hear and recognise many of the problems associated throughout Banbridge, Lurgan and Portadown to be reflected in towns such as Wormpoint, Kilkeel, Downpatrick, right across my constituency. They're not unique, although it has to be said, like other constituencies, Upper Bann does have its uniqueness. And I suppose, like everywhere, we have to work to our strengths and really create a tailored approach to what is going to revive the high street in those areas. For example, I know that the council invest in Lurgan Show, and I believe that the public park there, which I learned is the largest public park on the island after Phoenix. Issues like that, whilst they are great and they draw crowds, the high street are actually not benefiting greatly from those. So it's having this creative way of thinking and playing to the strengths of the area. I look again at the Portadown, for example, while you have the Seago Hotel, many of us would look on in envy. Yes, Shirley.
Thank you very much. I actually welcome the point that you made in relation to Lurgan Show and the park and Brownlow House. Significant investment, I believe, is needed in terms of linking those very much with the town centre. I welcome the investment from the council in Brownlow House, but I would encourage the executive to look towards Brownlow House as well, because you make a very, very valid point.
And the member has an extra minute.
Thank you. I agree completely. And I look at Ónaid Envy, at hotels like Seago in Portadown, and then also thinking of the industrial hub in Craigavon. But unfortunately, visitors to that area very often have to, when they go to Seago, have to perhaps travel to hotels elsewhere to finish their visit or go elsewhere. So they're looking at hotels and the whole connectivity of what features are already in place, how they can be built on, and how they directly link in to the high street. I know my former colleague Dolores Kelly did much work on the rail service, for example, as being an important feature of creating access to towns and to town centres. I looked through also the statistics about the vacancy rates in Upper Bann, and of course we would like them all to sit at 0%, and nothing short of that is where we should be aiming at. But the 20% and 27% and 25%, in real terms, walking along the street, that's one in every three and four shops is a shutter down, and that image itself is not enticing customers or potential customers to even visit the town centre. We have rightly identified things such as changes in shopping habits, the growth of internet shopping, the growth of out-of-town retailing, parking and traffic issues, and infrastructure, including the rail links, as I mentioned. But essentially, The government has to play its part in keeping our town centres vibrant, and by stimulating not just the local economy, this will then play in well to our regional and national economies. Our main streets and high streets play a significant role in that national economy, and it's so much part of the bigger picture. The high street provides jobs and distributes goods and services and are a place of investment. We cannot afford to see this investment slip. Yes.
Would the member agree that whilst the department and the local authorities can do all they can to improve town centres, that really the responsibility for a vibrant town centre lies with the residents of the town? And I think there is a big responsibility on local residents to support local businesses. And if they do that, there will be less shutters going down and there will be more businesses coming into our town centres.
I do agree, and I think we are all stakeholders, and like the member mentioned earlier, there are different arguments and different sides of the argument and people wanting support one thing over another, but essentially we all have a part to play in this, and you're absolutely right, but it's making it enticing. Customers will not come unless there is an offer in place. So basically looking at what is within the power of this house or government, if you like, is that investment must continue, and we must look at why have regeneration powers not yet been handed over to local council areas. The delay in those powers is really quite unacceptable at this stage, and the regeneration bill, which was not brought forward during the last mandate, would have given an extension of the powers to council to address the social need and carry out the regeneration schemes. It really undermines the reform of local government, and the power of planning and community planning and the regeneration powers can go together and play a greater role in sharpening and regenerating our town centres, and the SDLP are calling again for regeneration powers to be transferred to local councils. Many councils have previously drawn down funds from OFM to AFM to regenerate their town centres to encourage footfall and to return to the town centres, but we need to get past this painting shutters to make them more attractive whilst they're closed. Business rates is within our gift.
Can
to
the
seriously
member bring her remarks to a close?
Thank you. Yes, business rates, I would ask the Minister to give a real thorough review on how he can work with other ministerial departments to make a real effective change.
The Member's time is up. I call the Minister.
Principal Deputy Speaker, can I thank Ms Seeley for the opportunity to speak this afternoon on town centres in Upper Bann, and thank all of those who have taken part and contributed to the debate. And it's clear from comments made that there are challenges there, but there's also been significant investment by my department to date on the regeneration of areas within Upper Bann, namely Banbridge, Central Craigavon, Lurgan and Portadown. And highlighted by a number of members, I was in Banbridge last month. I was delighted to see my colleagues there, Mr Anderson, Carla Lockhart and John O'Dowd, who came along to that and was able to engage with me on the issues around Banbridge. Urban regeneration and community development activities are designed to help reverse economic, social and physical decline in areas where market forces will not do this without the support of government. I am committed to taking forward and delivering regeneration programmes that aim to tackle area-based deprivation, make our towns and cities more competitive, link up areas of need with areas of opportunity and develop more connected and engaged communities. To make our towns more competitive, I firmly believe in the need to build the strongest possible framework for investment and business growth. My department has led the development and publication of master plans for all the urban towns within Upper Bann. These documents provide the strategic vision and future direction for all stakeholders that have an interest in the development of our towns and cities over the next 10 to 15 years. These plans seek to develop and promote the unique characteristics of each town. Councils will also play a key role in taking responsibility for the development of their towns, and it's important that councils take the lead in driving forward investment and business growth in their district. And my department will play a full role working with councils on the implementation of their community development powers and progression of local development plans. Can I say that Upper Bann, I believe, is strategically positioned in terms of access to major roads, airports and seaports. Government will need to work together to continue to improve the infrastructure to maximise the opportunities needed to improve and sustain access to markets. Investment is important to our economic development because town centres are vital to the economic life of Northern Ireland, and since 2008 my department has directly invested approximately £10 million in regenerating the town centres of Banbridge, Central Craigavon, Lurgan and Portadown. This has been matched with local government and private sector investment of approximately £4.2 million. So I would suggest to members that that investment is slightly more than just a shop frontage painting up job that was suggested earlier. Towns face many challenges, not least from the increased competition that internet shopping brings, and that's been highlighted by other members. Mr O'Dowd touched upon it, Mr Chambers touched upon it. The changing way in which consumers go about their business is very much driving change in the retail sector, and how we can assist businesses, particularly in town centres, to try and tap into that and to respond to it. But ultimately, consumer is king, or queen for that matter, whenever it comes to deciding where they're going to shop. And Mr O'Dowd rightly pointed out of town shopping centres are here to stay. I support my own out of town centre in Sprucefield because of its strategic location in Northern Ireland, and that presents a tension when it comes to town centre traders. But that is the consumer who ultimately is going to dictate where they're going to spend their money. Government cannot do that, but we can assist our businesses to try and present environments in which the consumer will want to come into town centres. But fundamentally, it is our businesses that need to recognise the changing environment that they are operating in, and I will seek to do all I can to help and assist them to tap into that market and how it's developing. Projects have included major improvements in Upper Bann to the public realm, which is the fabric of our town centres, which provides the attractive shared spaces that residents and visitors can enjoy and supports local trade and enterprise. Lurgan and Portadown have benefited from multi-million pound investments, making them more attractive and inviting to all. We've also delivered a number of revitalisation projects where the traders and businesses within the town centres have had input to provide a tailored package of initiatives to meet the needs of their town. These initiatives have included sprucing up shop frontages, the provision of free Wi-Fi, new planters, shrouding of derelict buildings, special events to help promote the town centres, landlord meetings, to name but a few. Local traders also recognise the benefit of these schemes, having invested their own money to improve the appeal of their business. So I know this is something that has attracted some commentary, that these shop frontages schemes somehow aren't worthwhile. I disagree with that, and it's testament to the fact that private businesses put in their own money as part of these schemes shows that they are important to cosmetically improve an area. But to suggest that we only ever do revitalisation schemes is not to present the accurate picture as to how the executive wants to support in much greater investment, which we have been able to do in Upper Bann. I'm aware that local traders often raise concerns about the need to introduce fairer rates and taxes to support existing and attract new businesses in the town centres, and I know that the Finance Minister is looking into this matter, and let me assure the House that I will work with my colleagues to provide support to local traders. It's an issue in my own constituency that was raised with me from businesses. Some benefited in our town centre and others were disadvantaged by the scheme that was carried out, but it was rightly pointed out by Mr O'Dowd that rates is something that has to be paid and has to be paid by someone. What's important is that we ensure a fair and equitable way in which that is shared across our society, and that of course is something that is open always for challenge, and rightly so. What I would say is that I believe landlords, in terms of the monies that they seek to extract from commercial enterprises through their rent levels, is as much an issue as it is to do with rates. When you consider how we have the lowest rates anywhere in the United Kingdom in Northern Ireland, we have introduced small business rate relief schemes, and we have helped to keep down the level that people are paying in rates. Obviously, some other councils have put rates up, others have kept theirs down, but when it comes to how much landlords are charging for rent, and that was an issue in my own constituency, then they need to be challenged about being realistic when it comes to the level of rent that they're going to receive for their properties, and that's an issue that needs to be addressed. My department has also supported the private sector to redevelop vacant and derelict sites through the Urban Development Grant Initiative. This scheme was reopened earlier this year, and there's been considerable interest across the province and from within the Upper Bann constituency. Upper Bann has one of the youngest populations in Northern Ireland, which helps to create the vibrant town centres, investing in education programmes through the department's Neighbourhood Renewal Programme. And that helps to support our young people to avail of new and emerging opportunities. This year alone, my department has invested over £1.5 million in three neighbourhood renewal areas within Upper Bann. The department supports local jobs, local towns, and has government offices in all the major towns within the constituency. Officials in Banbridge and Craigavon continue to work in close partnership with council colleagues to deliver urban regeneration in the town centres of Banbridge, Lurgan and Portadown. And there is much physical evidence to attest to the success of this working partnership. As I touched on earlier, master plans have been developed. I launched the one in Banbridge recently, and already some of those initiatives have been identified and are progressing. Urban regeneration is fundamental to ensuring our town centres remain vital and viable, and that's why I'm committed to continuing to invest in this area. Finally, just picking up on some points, I think it is vital that we do seek to maximise the opportunities that exist currently in terms of helping to support our town centres, and we are looking to have future investment in the Upper Bann constituency. Carla touched on this earlier. So the marketing strategy was mentioned by Ms Seeley, and that is something that there will be a marketing strategy developed as part of the revitalisation scheme. There will be £2 million invested in Portadown over the next 2 years to take forward the linkages project, and that will help further improve the public realm, and there are other schemes. So let us take the opportunities to support our local businesses. Let's take the opportunity presented by Brexit. I know that Upper Bann voted to leave the European Union, and you now have reduced sterling to attract people from the south to come in as trade has developed. And so there are opportunities that I believe that your area could be seeking when it comes to the lower sterling that currently exists. So let's look at the opportunities.
Can the Minister bring his remarks to a close?
So let's look at the opportunities that there are and maximise those and work with our independent retailers and town centres to the benefit of everybody.
The Assembly is adjourned.